Articulation, and specifically one articulation, but I'll let you guys figure it out as we go along. It's actually more important that you hear it than see it. And then we had to get the guitar solo, of course. So can you guys guess the name of that song? Yes.
Smooth.
It's Smooth by, it's Smooth by Santana. So did you notice anything about the guitar solo? Like what kind of articulation he's using? Yes.
Staccato.
So smooth, right? So do
Oh,
do
legato.
do 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 do. That's right. That's right.
Is that what you think for quicken?
Yes, that's right. Very good. Very good. So today our focus is how can we achieve that same smoothness in our singing. So let's start with some warm-ups. And for this, I want you guys to think like this swan gliding across the water when we're singing.
That's some real computer animated art.
It looks cool though. So just imagine a real swan. And for this, I want you guys to draw an arc with your finger. So we're gonna start
Let's just
here.
start the swan.
Yeah, you wanna start the swan over? Okay. Is that possible?
Come on.
Sweet.
No, it's there you go.
Sweet.
Now you're done. Now you're
Thank you.
old.
Okay, well, just keep this in mind. So remember, we're drawing an arc with our arm. So this warm-up goes, "Oh, how I love to sing." Tenors. Now back down. Bass is back in. So looking at the swan here, still going. He's just a gliding. It's great, and that's exactly what we want for our sound. Exactly. Never stop the swan and never stop the sound. All right, guys. So this next warm-up is going to be on the syllable nu. So can you say that with me? Lots of space. No. Yes, very good, very good. So we'll start here, and the warm-up goes like this. Ready? Does that make sense?
Yep.
Yeah? Alright, let's try it. Ready? This to say, the term legato, right? Have you guys heard that before?
Yeah.
All right, so to review, legato comes from the Italian word legare, which means to tie together. So just like this chain link fence, or not fence, but just chain links, we're connecting all of our notes together like this. So one goes into the next. Yep. So legato is a type of articulation. And then we'll get to more in the next couple days. So the essential question is, how can we modify how we say words, so our diction, so that we can sing in a more legato style? So I'm going to sing this excerpt from the Hallelujah Chorus. We're at letter C. And I'm going to sing it through twice, and I want you guys to tell me which one was the more legato one. So, here we go. Just me, just listen. The kingdom of this world is become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ. All right, that's the first time. Now here's the second time. Listen once more. The kingdom of this world is become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ. So which time? Yeah, two. Very good. Very good answer. So what parts of my singing or like what do you think made it more smooth?
The connection between the notes.
Exactly. That too. That's a great point. So where are we breathing, right? How are we connecting the notes together? There's one more thing. It has to do with consonants. Can you guys think of something? Anybody? Anyone? Yeah, okay, in the back.
You're like kind of like not stopping.
Perfect. That's exactly what I was looking for. So yes, exactly. Those three things, right? Where are we breathing? How are we connecting our notes? And not staying on the consonants. So just like clothespins on a clothesline. Exactly. So let's give it a try, you guys. I'm just going to have you guys sing along. Let's start with basses, pickups to C, with all of that in mind. So you can use your finger if you want, just to indicate the line. Think about this idea. Oh, it turned off. Think about this chain link idea. Oh, do you want to do the swan? We can do the swan.
Swan's very peaceful.
I agree. And that's the idea of this section, is this nice swan here.
And he will swim forever.
Exactly. All right. So let's give this a shot here. One, two, three. The kingdom of this world. One, two. Is become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ. Just that much. Okay? Now, you guys want to give it a try without me singing? I'll play along. Ready? And same spot. One, two, ready. I like you guys' legato, but how can we make it project a little bit more? Anyone? Yes?
Space.
That's right. Can I get some more space on the vowels? And that'll help connect the notes even more. So one more time, then I'll get to tenors. One, two, right. Good. Yeah, I heard a lot more space there. Nice job, guys. Tenors, you ready? Okay. One, two, three.
The kingdom of this world.
One, two.
Is become the kingdom of the Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ.
Good. Yes. My bad about that one note. So one more time for me. Same spot. One, two, three.
The kingdom of this world is become the kingdom of the Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ.
Yeah, so one, two, three. Yeah, one, two, off. Does that make sense? That way we can get right off so the basses can come in with the, and he shall reign. Yeah, exactly. So let's try it together. What do you guys think? Or do you want to do it one more time, tenors?
Let's do it together.
Okay, that sounds good.
Let's just go for it.
Okay. Yes. Okay, let's try it. One, two, three.
This world
of his Christ. That's all right. Let's start. The mezzo forte is become. I'm going to sing the bass part and then play the tenor part, so it'll be easier. One, two. Is become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ. Was that, did that feel better? A little bit? Okay, let's try it one more time from the top. One, two, three.
The kingdom of his world is become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ and of his Christ.
Good, yeah. Yeah. So we are running out of time here, as far as my 15-minute lesson. But let's do one more thing really quickly. So what have we learned today about the legato articulation? Smooth. Good.
Connected.
Connected.
This one will go forever.
Yes. What was the other visual?
The chain link.
That's right. So which one are we going for? This one? This one?
Chain linking.
This one. Right? Exactly. And what are some ways we can use our actual mouths? Space. Good. What about consonants?
Diction.
Yeah, the diction. What about it? That's good concepts, but what about our diction can we change? What about the consonants?
We need to make sure that the consonants stick out, but not too much.
Right, so just like clothespins on a line. That too. Very good, guys. Thanks.